I am here with Raja Cooks at her very own house, invited for a baking session with her. So she's gonna guide me. As you know, I'm not a baker, but we are gonna go. My mentor, I call her my mommy, I call her Raja, I call her auntie. But she's me gestop om te say, I'm not your auntie, Raja. But let's get started. Okay, so to start with our base of our cake, we're gonna need 2 cups of sugar.
And with baking, guys, as I told Dario, it's you must use the exact amount. You can't deviate from it. Even not with baking. Okay, gooi in. No, gooi maar in. Ja, gooi in.
And then okay, beetje. And then we're gonna carry on. Okay, next is gonna be 2 cups of cake flour that we're gonna sift in here. So. I'm gonna mess here.
That's my. So yeah. Ayo, yeah. Okay, and another one.
Can I just do that?
Mm. Almost any back, that's fine. So we move.
And then we'll be right back. Are we gonna sift this, guys? We're gonna switch the oven on to 180 degrees, but we're gonna add the rest of the dry ingredients. But I'll be right back. I'm so nervous. I'm cooked the back. And then we are gonna add 2 teaspoons of baking powder, but it's gonna be 1, right, guys? In 1 for a bit of lifter.
Yeah, and I can't eat extra in for you.
So,
yeah.
So it's 2 teaspoons, but I call it 1 teaspoon, and it's sweeter enough for a bit of lifter. And then we're gonna go in with 1.5 teaspoon of bicarb baking soda, or just bicarb. So we're gonna go in.
Raja, what do you have? How much cake flour is in there?
2 cups.
2 cups cake flour, 1.5 cup of sugar.
Two cups of sugar.
Back again.
Mr. Pro salt meer, is that zeker?
Okay. It's and then we're gonna add not a heap teaspoon, but you saw that, no? Of salt.
And that is a half because I used the half of that, so you can chuck that in.
No, this is a lot. A teaspoon.
No, a half a cup.
Oh, a half a cup. Yeah, okay, so this is worth a half a cup of cocoa powder, which we're gonna add all in there. And you're gonna sift that also in. Right now. And then we're gonna mix this all together. And this is a Raja Cooks recipe that we are making. So this one is a flock proof free one. We'll be right back. Next, 2 room temperature eggs we're gonna add in.
This is now your wet ingredients that's going in, eh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, 2 eggs, room temperature eggs has gone in, and then 1 cup of milk. And again, you can most likely use any milk if you want to use skim milk. Yeah. The quantities or amounts stay the same.
Yeah. Go in, chuck it in. And then 1/2 cup of oil. Huh? So that's the 1/2 cup measurement thing there.
Oh, is that tall?
1/2 cup of oil. Oh, I can confused geraak with the oil in the milk.
With the oil? Oh.
I said now, yeah.
And again, any oil of your choice. If you want to use olive oil or whatever, you go in with what you have.
Preferably not olive oil, because olive oil has got a very pungent flavor. No?
So this is a half a cup.
So this is a very neutral kind of flavor.
Okay.
1/2 cup of oil, yes.
Okay, so over here we have 1 cup, your normal teacup worth of boiling water. So we're going to put in 3 teaspoons of coffee. Like Raja says, you can use any coffee of your choice. If you like Dow, if you like your Nescafe, whatever, you can go in with what you have.
If it's those strong coffees, no? Rather to drink just the one or two teaspoons. Because this is not very potent, the tea coffee. That's why I'll add more here.
Okay, you heard that. We'll be back. And you throw a drizzle of boiling in there, right though?
And then a cap full of the vanilla essence, no?
And then a cap full of vanilla essence.
I throw in like, if I now say in spoons, I'll say 2 teaspoons, no?
So, a cap full of this.
And that you must throw in, like, you must smell it, yeah.
I see how you sometimes go in with a pichimere because I can't get the vanilla smell from liquor.
So with ikiti kukabak from scratch.
Yeah, you heard it, you heard right. So we're going to mix this in now.
Do you smell the coffee? Do you smell the vanilla?
I do smell the coffee and the vanilla.
Well, that is how the taste, the cake is going to taste.
Oh, yeah. Interesting. Anyway, we're going to continue mixing this, and when we are done, we're going to move to our oven.
Yeah, you must first grease the plachina with butter and flour. Yeah.
I have to put her in because she wants to stand here on the side, you know. But guys, do and go and give her a follow. Her TikTok handle is Khaja Saido Cooks. It's Khadija Saido.
Khadija Saido.
Yeah, Khadija Saido. Khaja
Cooks.
Her username is Khaja Cooks. Go and give her a follow. That's your
username. I didn't even know that.
Go and give her a follow, guys. I will appreciate it if you do. Okay, so Khadija's going to take over this part, guys.
Honey.
Oh, she's honey.
Me,
that's what she does.
And on the side, everywhere.
Okay, so and you can take, this is Rama, you can obviously take
whichever butter
you like to use, and then you're just gonna baste the
Can you go fetch your apron bottom. In the court, Dario?
It's an ugly one. You're gonna baste the bottom of your pan like that, and then next we are gonna add in our...
Just spread this nicely with your... Because
it's now it's so yellow. So, we've spread it out evenly. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to take some flour and just dust it.
For what now?
Over your base of your Pyrex dish, plachi, whatever you want to call it. Like that. Just like that. And then we're going to add in the main ingredient, which is going to be...
As you can see, you know, just show them this is not a very, it's a very runny base. Don't be alarmed when you see it like this. No? Don't throw anything in. It's supposed to be like this. This is what makes it so light moist. And airy, because it's not a very dense base. It's very thin. Okay, as you can see, you must be so careful.
Okay, and here we go. Bismillah.
Look at that chocolate goodness.
Yes.
Here we go. I last the pitchy 8. Okay, that's enough here. Okay.
And then we'll be back. Okay, next we're gonna place it into our preheated oven for 30 to 35 minutes. And then, so you, in order for you to check if it is right, you take your toothpick or you take any stick that you have, you poke it in, and if it comes out clean, then you know your cake is done. Anyway, we'll show you once we start doing the things over here. So guys, while the cake is in, I forgot to record this.
I'm busy cutting up the steak
into strips. We're gonna make my famous Ruchi Gatsby. Full house masala steak Ruchi Gatsby. So we've rinsed the meat, we've cut them up in strips. Now we're going to place them back in our bowl, give them one last rinse, and then we're going to start with that. But we're not going to make content about this, because if you go on my profile, you will see my full house masala steak Gatsby that I sell, that I make. So we'll be back when the cake is done. Okay, we're going to take out the cake now. It's been in for about 30-35 minutes, like I said, Yela. And this is looking absolutely amazing. Here we go. at all.
The smell.
And we're gonna let this cake cool off.
Yeah.
Until it's completely cooled off, because you can't put any creams or icings or whatever on it because it's just gonna melt. So we'll be right back, Ella.
Snowflakes.
So over there, Khaja is showing you what she likes to do when the cake has cooled down a little bit. So she just sprinkles over some icing sugar, and you can carry on.
Not a lot, just like I threw in a tablespoon in here. Because we are going to have this with custard.
Guys, we immediately got dipping into the food and into our dessert that we made. But this is what it looks like. I'm going to take a bite and show you what it looks like. But I hope you enjoyed it. Please follow this recipe as is and you won't go wrong. It is so light, so soft, and it goes great with a custard, ultra melt. Beautiful. Khaja, my friend, and Da, I love you guys so, so much. Thank you for a great day. Thank you for this beautiful recipe. I'm gonna try this on my own again. But anyway, Ella, thank you so much for watching. Bye.